is it? What
are you going for?
So I see all the places.
More paper?
Oh, and our reason we're getting to like 48 or more people.
Okay. In the back pocket of that binder, there are more lists, but it says exhibition at the bottom. Have Aubrey cross that out, put event, and then tell Greg the number of people here. Plug them in. No, they're not, will you?
Thank you.
You're fine. Leave me alone.
out of those lines. This looks like someone's taking like those glasses. It's like I see.
Thank you. Thank you. I definitely want to send a really heartfelt thank you.
We had to cut about half of the show. It was really, and I feel like sometimes you guys see a juror get up there and say, it was really hard. And you just feel like they're blowing smoke. Not even remotely. It was so hard to figure out what to pull out of the show, because I am genuinely 100% blown away by the work that you put in here. Presenting. Maybe some of you put in, like, ah, whatever, it's just for this assignment in class, but you made some incredibly exceptional work. And you should be extremely proud of yourselves for submitting to this process. It is really, really puts yourself in a vulnerable position to let someone else who doesn't know anything about you, doesn't know anything about your work, kind of blind judge it and say, this is fine, yeah, this works, this doesn't, this doesn't work. So I appreciate that. And I want you to know that you should be very proud of yourselves, period. Anyone who submitted, thank you. This is a very important part of your career as an artist. And I have definitely been on the other side a million times. So it's very, very awesome to do this. I do want to mention, and I don't want to talk forever because I have to talk forever tomorrow, so I want to just mention this too. This is a very pivotal point in your art career if perchance your piece did not make it in today. I want you to take a deep breath. And I want you to remind yourself that this is a piece of work you made. It is not the culmination of you. The show gets juried, and as I start pulling pieces out, the show starts kind of talking to me, and it starts kind of becoming a little bit more cohesive. So I juried out a lot of pieces that I thought were exceptional on their own, but didn't quite fit the narrative of the show as it started to come together. I also want to remind you that this is a very subjective process. I'm going to give you two little stories just before we get into this, but I personally, I'm from Kalamazoo, Michigan. There is a show at Kalamazoo called the West Michigan Area Show. It's at the Kalamazoo Institute of Arts. When I was a little kid, I went to that show every year. It was my dream to be in that show. Because I was this big, I assumed that that was the biggest show in the world. That's where all the big artists would be. And so, eventually, I made a piece in my undergrad, and I was like, this is it. This is the piece. It's perfect. My professors think it's great. I think it's great. I bet you know how the story ends. I didn't get in. And I was completely devastated. I was like, there's no way that this couldn't happen. Gotten in the show, let alone won, my ego was getting so big, won an award. But it didn't make it in the show. It's completely devastating. And so my professor, and I would say this is another little asterisk to listen to your professors, because they do have more experience in this than you, asked me to submit the same piece to a national show in New York City, Society of Illustrators, which is if any of you are in illustration, it's a really big deal for that Society of Illustrators. Norman Rockwell, Weingarten, all of those Illustrators, Golden Age Illustrators, so they went. The piece got accepted to that show, which is way more prestigious because all subjective. Whoever the jurors, whatever he had for lunch, whatever he had for breakfast that day, can affect their judgment. My wife's grandfather had a similar situation. He's a ceramist. That's the worst ceramicist. There it is, ceramicist. There it is. So, same thing. Couldn't get in, and this is one of those things where, like, the local. Whatever show, this the local gallery couldn't get into the show with one of his pieces, won a national award for the same piece as he submitted to a second show. So do not feel like this is the end of your career, but even the end of that piece of art's career. Please submit to more things. Please keep trying. Please keep submitting. It does get easier, the rejection. It's never fun, but it does get easier the more you do it. And you start to realize that it does depend. The juror. And it is not a reflection on you at all. It's always about the work, always about the show, always about the cohesiveness. So that's my little two bits about that. I just really want to make sure that you understand that this is not the end. This should only be the start of your career. This should be, you got in, fantastic. If you didn't, double down next year you do the show, double down. I want to see 140 pieces. And I want you to make the juror next year pull their hair out, because some of the students, you know, to make gallery employees help me, and I probably drove them insane by how many times I walked around the galleries, keep looking at the work, keep admiring it, keep looking. Really, truly, from the bottom of my heart, I'm honored to be able to judge a show and to look at your work. And I really genuinely want to say thank you for participating in this. Congratulations to you. That's and I will say it was unbelievably hard to pick awards. And not only was my part like just ground up in a mush during out of work, but I thought it was great. Then it was, well, on top of that, we need to kind of pick some awards. And so I spent a lot of time thinking about this. I spent a lot of time in the gallery yesterday, came back today. Spent the entire night thinking about this. Like, I didn't get a lot of sleep last night because I was kind of like, okay, well, what about this piece? What is that piece? And so when I came back in today and saw the show going up, it was just kind of like, it's amazing. So the pieces were just like, oh, no, this is it. Like, they just started singing to me. I'm like, I see it now. And so some of the choices, I will say, maybe you don't agree with it. And that's 100% okay. I'm more than happy to talk to you about any of the pieces we chose for the award, any of the pieces I got. I will again remind you, it's extremely subjective, and so, but I'm happy to help you understand, you know, and I would say too, it's not how you get in next year, but help you understand maybe why you didn't fit the show this time. I'm happy to talk to you about that. But I would love to, I know why you're here, it's here to hear those awards, so I'd love to jump into that right now. Is there anything else I'd like to do? Okay. All right, so. Let's go with numerical awards first. And I'm going to butcher your names. I'm just going to throw that out right now. So if it makes you feel better, my last name is TenBusschen. And Greg didn't say that. TenBusschen. It doesn't look like that at all. So it doesn't mean anything to you. It's horrible. It's horrible. The dogs are terrible. I just can't name them. All right, so Alex Jimenez.
He's six.
Okay, so let's. That was for Abstraction, sure. Which is over on the shelf over there, the screen printed book.
Yep. Wait, he can always watch and hear what we have to say.
Oh, okay.
You're just awesome. You have this album, right?
An absolutely stunning piece. Beautiful to look through. You have not spent any time. I know there's gloves over there for you to look through. Very careful with it. Wonderful, wonderful piece, wonderful concept. Beautifully executed. And this is one of those pieces where the craftsmanship really spoke, really solid. So I don't want to spend too much time. He's not here, so he's not here. He can't be that excited for him. So we move on. So let's see what we've got over here. Amanda Anderson for Mind Over Matter.
Yeah.
Oh, there you are. Perfect. All right. Fantastic piece. This is one of those things that's really interesting. I'm going to just say this as kind of a general thing. I'm a figurative painter, and so I see that I really was intrigued by it. There's a level of abstraction that's happening in that piece, plus the technical difficulty that we're doing these things. And I will tell you this before. Anyone here is net price way higher. Are you kidding me? Come on, seriously. If you accidentally find that price, that thing, come on, it's a beautiful piece. And so I think you did a fantastic job. Excellent work. Thank you for submitting that. All right, let's see what we've got here. Rhonda Winkweiger. Something that is extremely important to me as a painter, seeing shapes, and just breaking things down. As I teach foundations and all of their early painting and drawing at Williston, it's all about shapes. And there's a wonderful rhythm to this piece. I love the saturated and just subdued, almost saturated tones in this as well.
well too, and the tactile texture. And yes, I did touch it a bunch. The one time I'm like in a gallery room, I can touch this stuff. All right, so there's something really wonderful about this, and its presence on the wall is just perfect. So very, very good job. Congratulations. All right, let's see. Who else we have? Enjoy this piece in the round. It's absolutely, I'm almost kind of mad because it was pushed up against the wall and there was just all of these beautiful colors projected on the wall. And I really love that. This is something too, and I would say this for a lot of the pieces. Not only the pieces that won awards tonight, but a lot of the pieces in here, I would have been extremely proud to produce any of these pieces in my undergrad. Truly fantastic. Absolutely engaging and just stunning show. You should give yourselves another hand for just enjoying. And thank you for letting me ramble on. So if you have questions, I would love to answer them. Or if you just want to beat me up, my name is Bill Harper. You can find me on social media, you can, you know, whatever it is, let's send all the hate back. Thank you so much for the opportunity. I really genuinely
So before you remember, we still do have one more award. It will be chosen at the end of the night tonight, and that's that Student's Choice Award. So grab a sticky note and put it by the piece you think is most deserving, Minot State University students home life. And then we will tally that up at the end of the night.
Great.
education.
Excellent.
Yeah, with the eye. Beautiful piece. Kind of curated out, didn't quite fit. But there's kind of a flow, as much as this isn't like a curated show, it's like specific to me, but as I started pulling things out, actually I put the drops of plastic in it. Just didn't quite flow with it. I think it's a wonderful piece. And like I did spend a hard time trying to get that drops out. This is awesome. Yeah. Once it, oh yeah, that's, you feel like you probably sedate that dog somehow. You know, peanut butter all over the cabin. Let me ask you a question about that photo of the dog. You know, that what process was
it?
Josephine, you're good.